What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Finesse, and today I'm at the Indian dealership with a brand new bike. Not my bike, but a brand new bike. Obviously, you can see it behind me. So this is a little departure from the norm, but it's exciting nonetheless. So what we have here is the Zero SRS. It's an electric sport bike, and this bike looks amazing. Like, there's so many little details on here that they did with this bike that I think makes it kind of stand out from, you know, some of the other sport bikes that look kind of, you know, they look kind of weird where you see like all the batteries and everything else. I mean, you can see some of the stuff here, but the fairings on it looks more like a traditional bike than anything. So at first glance, you wouldn't even think it's an electric bike. But yeah, man, it is really, really nice. And this color, I was on the website last night and I was trying to find the color. This is the only color that it comes in, but it didn't give it a name. I mean, it looks like a, almost kind of like the Destroyer Gray from Dodge. Kind of like a in between, like it's like a milky gray, greenish tinted color to it. But it's beautiful, beautiful. It's a beautiful bike. All right. So I'm gonna just go through a few specs while you guys take a look at it right there. It's like I said, it's the Zero SRS. It has 124 mile an hour top speed. It has 140 foot pounds of torque. Look, 140 foot pounds of torque, and you get that instantly because it's an electric. Oh my goodness! All right, so 110 horsepower. It's got like a 227 mile an hour range. That's, of course, with the top-of-the-line battery. I think they call it the power tank. And it charges from empty to a full charge in 54 minutes. Less than an hour to fully charge this bike. Whew, okay. All right, so in the city, though, you're getting about 156 miles. So, you know, your commute back and forth to work. Maybe you're just going to bike night, you know, taking a short ride here and there. Either way, I mean, I don't think you're gonna be too disappointed with it. So, all right, let's get in here, man. Let's get in here and take a look at it. Look at this, man. Look at that. Oh. So there's a Showa suspension. This one has the Z-Force 7510. So I'm not exactly sure what that means. As I was on the site, so you know, this electric stuff is all new to everybody. You know, you figure a few years from now we're gonna be like, oh yeah, 7510, you know, this that and the other. But man, this is a beautiful bike. It's got the little piggyback and it says Showa on it right there. That is nice. The finish on these bikes is beautiful. Like the gaps, the body gaps. Yeah, look at the rear set. It connects here for the rider, and then it comes up here for the passenger. Not connected to anything, it's just like floating. And you know, it is what it is, but that is beautiful just looking at it. And then of course you got your little pigtail here for your accessories and whatnot, just your standard pigtail. And then you got the motor here, and then you got the battery up here. All right. And look at where the mirrors are mounted. The mirrors are mounted on the body. You know, typically you'll see them up here on the fairing, but it's more inside here in the body. I'm curious to know if that'll keep like vibrations down or whatnot. But I mean, there's no motor, so there's not going to be a lot of vibration anyway. But you know, just riding, you know, getting the body shake and everything else. So let's see what size wheels we got on here. Comes with some Pirellis. You got some 120 70 ZR17s on the front. On the back, you have a 180 55 ZR17. All right, so here's the other side. You got your rear brake right here, and you got your front brake up here. Of course, it's battery, so there's no clutch. And it being battery, this is where you charge it at. There's a charging port right there. So this is your standard charging port for, I think it's like a RJ45 is what they call it. So nice and convenient. You don't have to go and pop off a panel to check it out or whatever. And also, it being a electric, you've got storage. Look at this storage, man. Like, you can, I mean, you could put like a few drinks in here. You got USB charging in here. I mean, come on, man. Like, you could charge your phone in there or whatever the case may be, or charging batteries for your cameras or, you know, whatever. Real cool. And there's also another storage. There's a storage back here. I don't know how to get that open. So let's go ahead and cycle the power on. So, well, before we get there, right? So you got your light controls, you got your flashing, your high beams, you got your normal, and then you push it forward for your high beam. And then you got your ride modes here. You have your indicators here. You got the horn there. You got your starter, and then you've got your, is that a throttle lock? It looks like it might be cruise control. That's crazy. Okay. Let's give her a cycle. Power up. Takes a second. The display on this is crisp. I mean, that is a good looking display. And then of course, you know, you got full LED. Well, not full LED. I know the headlights are LED, but I see here there's not LEDs there. All right, so like I was saying, man, this is the ZF7510 motor. I'm thinking this is the only option, but this is the latest from Zero, the 7510. So standard, it comes with a 14.4 kilowatt hour battery. The premium version has a 15.6 premium kilowatt hour battery, and both of those are lithium ion. There's also an option for a 17.3 upgrade, and I think that's what they were calling the power pack. All right, so it's also equipped with the latest Cypher 3 operating system, and there's downloadable performance upgrades. So if you're familiar with like a e-bike, like the bicycles, there's one in the background back there. If you're familiar with the e-bikes, they have those apps on your phone where you can unlock more power, basically. So you end up going from 20 to 25 miles an hour. So it's the same thing with this. You get on the website, download the app, and you can control those upgrades through your phone. So that's really cool, man. It's got a trellis frame, like I said before, the Showa suspension and the Boss stability control. The base price starts at $25,995, and the premium is at a $22,695. And then obviously there's gonna be some upgrades and options from there. It's got a 31 inch seat height. So from your inseam to the ground, 31 inches, which is, that's pretty comfortable. I don't think you're gonna have to be too tall to get on that. So I'm 5'9 with a 33 inch seam, I think. 33 inch inseam. At 5'9", so I get on there and there's ample room to flat foot it. And then it also comes with a 5-year unlimited mile warranty on the power pack. I mean, just check on the website and they'll give you all the details about that. But yeah, man, look, and those headlights. At first I thought they were like a square with a bunch of vertical bars in it. But it's just a reflector, but it still has a crazy look to it though. And of course they're LEDs. Oh, this is a good looking bike. This is a good looking bike. So what we're gonna do now is see if we can't get it out, go for a test ride, and then I'll let you guys know how I feel about it. The JT snuck in the side over here. He didn't think I saw him. He ain't mic'd up now. He should have been, but he ain't. But what do you think about it, man?
I think it's nice.
Yeah, you think it looks all right? Hey, it's all about operator control, man.
Yeah.
But all right, y'all. Hey, so, oh, and the seating position, like it looks like it's a crotch rocket, but it's not. It has more of a standard seating position. Oh, look at that. JT's hooking it up. Look at that. He's sitting more upright. Here, pop your right leg up. I mean, put it on the, yeah. Yeah, so it's a upright, more of an upright feeling or sitting than actual sport bike. So yeah, I get a hold of Chris, see if we can't get this bad boy outside and give you guys a review. What's going on, peoples? I'm at Indian Dealership, and I ran into a subscriber, man. It's about that time. What? So he's got a Indian Challenger as well. It's a beautiful, beautiful white smoke bike, man. Look at that. And you can go ahead and introduce yourself, sir.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Dwight. I'm living in Orlando.
So nice.
Just out enjoying the day. You know, did some early riding on Friday. Did an Iron Butt. And I'm
okay.
Just kind of making my way back to Orlando.
You did Iron Butt with Wood?
No.
Oh, you did your own Iron Butt. Okay.
Yeah, I did with my IMRG group out of Sanford, Florida.
Man, y'all got an IMRG?
Yes, sir.
Oh, man, I'm going to have to come all the way to Florida for IMRG.
Come on down.
Yeah, no. How far of a drive is it?
It was 1,000 miles in 24
no,
hours.
No. I mean, how far is it to where you're at?
Oh, I apologize. To get back down there, it's another 4 hours from here.
4 hours?
4.5 hours.
Oof. Yeah. Huh? Because I don't know if you're going to make it, bro. Hey, I can do 4 hours, you know. Anyway, all right, let's look at this bike, man. Oh, that is beautiful.
Thank you.
Is this your first bike?
Second bike.
Yeah, what were you on before this?
She's a little dirty. The first one I had was a Kawasaki Vulcan 900 Classic.
Vulcan, okay.
Yeah.
You had the Vulcan. You know, you had a... Oh, okay, all right. That seems like the progression. People go from, like, those type of...
Right.
Up into... Okay. And how long did you have that for?
A few months.
Okay.
So
you only had a few months, and then you were like, the heck with it. I'm getting
Indian. Well, I was just my wife and I were just getting back into the States. We were living outside in China for about 8 years, and then I had a little small CC motorcycle over there.
Okay.
And by the time we came back to the States,
yeah.
Okay, give me a bike.
Yeah.
So that was the first thing, and then when this came out, I was like, okay, yeah, got to get that
for sure. The China. Well, what do you do?
I taught English over there, but right now I work at a college in Leesburg, Florida.
That is fantastic, yeah. Man. So you're a teacher. That's all right. That's good stuff, man. So what mods have you done?
Tab Performance.
Of course,
mufflers,
look at that.
Of course.
Woo.
Small sissy bar. Got the intake airflow. Got a custom made sheepskin.
Oh, the sheep, only the finest of skins.
That's right.
How is it? Did it make it better?
Oh, yeah, it helps.
Yeah,
helps.
Does it? Okay. All right. And then I see you got your saddlebag lights.
Yep, got the saddlebag lights.
Shorty. So my antenna fell off.
Did it?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
As soon as I put the tab on, I guess it rumbled off. I didn't have it on good.
Yeah, so that's about it. That's about it. I got a Freedom windshield.
Okay.
And I got a few other things that I'm trying to do coming up soon. New handlebars.
Nice.
Headlight. I just ordered from Clockworks
the
screen right here.
Mm.
So that's coming in soon.
The headlight. What do you? I mean, like, is it not? Because I know what you. I know how it is, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because when I first got mine, it seemed like it stopped like right here.
Right.
You know, but I actually pitched it up a bit.
Okay.
And it ended up being okay. But I mean, is it?
Just doesn't seem as bright for me. So I'm looking at that Hogworks.
Hogworks, yeah.
It's got the halo around it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Nice. All right. Ain't nothing wrong with it, man. That's good. Oh, yeah. All right. Well, hey, bro. It was nice to meet you.
For sure.
Yeah,
good
man.
Seeing you in
I appreciate
person,
you. Yeah, for sure. Hey, you know we got to get him a sticker. Come on now. Come on now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Freedom
too. Yep.
Everybody got fancy windshields now. All right. Hey, I'm looking at getting bars myself, man. I had to clear up my financial advisor.
Oh, for sure.
There you go, my
Thank
man.
Thank you. I appreciate it for that.
Yeah, man. I appreciate the sub, bro. All right, y'all. Hey, so we're going to go ahead and wrap this up. I'm going to hop on that e-bike, and let's get it. All right, y'all. We are on the Zero SRS. All right, hit the on switch, get the dials going. This bike is super quiet, so you should be able to hear me talking. All right, turn the old power on. So now we've got the little indicator right here. I don't know if you can see that in this picture or not. There's a green indicator letting you know that the bike is on, and I'm reaching for the clutch that we don't have, so I'll pop it up on the brake here. All having any noise, and you're just twisting the throttle, basically. Your bike goes. It is effortless at the speed. And also, of course, you got your regenerative braking, and you can feel it too. I mean, it's more than engine braking. The feel, it has there's a distinct drag. Braking is serious. Mode or any of the crazy modes you can get into. This is just straight up
regular everyday get on the bike and move, you are gonna have some fun. You're gonna have some crazy fun on this bike.
So this bike, I mean, look, I don't know how they market it on the website. You'll see on there, and they talk about all the great things. You know, they always talk about great things, but just from a pure fun aspect, this bike is so much fun. And that was just going down the street. I can only imagine living with this thing. I don't know if I would ride this or if I'd ride my cruiser, man. I don't know. The Challenger, I might have to rename the channel or something. If I had an extra 20 grand sitting around, I would definitely add this to my stable. But be things as it may, you know, we all got a budget. Some more than less. But this is a really, really fun bike. It feels like you're just floating across the road and you don't hear anything. And all you're doing is just concentrating on the ride. And the little twist of throttle that I gave it, I mean, and it's, like I said, it's in standard mode. It's not in sport mode or any of the other, like the add-on that you get from the app. This is just straight from the factory, straight off the cuff. Let's get used to it. Let's do some turns, whatever. Amazing. But if you're in the market for an e-bike, it is all that and then some. If this is where we're going for the future, then, I mean, I don't think this isn't going to replace like the cruisers, right? Because, you know, you're going across the country and, you know, you're not going to be sitting and stopping at a place for an hour for it to charge. You know, you're trying to get to where you're going because you only get like 200 miles range, right? So this is not going to replace cross-country biking. However, in the cities, on the back road somewhere, just going to grab something, going to hang out with some guys or girls or whatever the case may be, that's where this bike is going to fit in. This bike is going to be the, you know, in the city, you know, New York or somewhere like Savannah downtown. You know, and you're just trying to get somewhere quick, get back home, whatever, or run some errands. It's going to be, this is where that bike is going to fit in. And I'm telling, man, this suspension, this Showa suspension. I mean, this thing is dialed in beautifully. It is dialed in. Like, you feel more wind than anything. And I know that's a lot of the excitement talking, but for real, man, like you feel the wind more than you feel the road, you know? So we're going to end that right here. I'm gonna head back. And then we'll get you on the next one. All right, y'all. I'm back into Finesse Garage. My time with the Zero bike was absolutely amazing. I wish I had more time on the bike, so that I could give you like a in-depth review or living with it for a week or whatever the case may be. But, you know, things as they are inventory wise and all that, you know, we're probably not going to be able to do those kind of things. I'm not going to say we're never able to do it because who knows, it may happen. But at this point in time right now, you know, I'm not able to do that. But, again, man, the bike was great. And I just wanted to clean up a few things. So that bike actually is for sale. I was talking to, Stacy, and she was, you know, matter of fact, hey, big shout out to Stacy, Bill, Mike, Eric, like all the guys up there, man, the service department, the sales team. My experience at this dealership has been phenomenal. It's been great. I've had a great time. Anytime I come through there, the guys are willing to talk to me about whatever. If I have an issue, they're always willing to solve the issue or make time to, you know, get something done. And that's not just me. I mean, I've seen other people who go in there and they're doing the same thing. So, really good dealership, man. And a big special shout out to Chris. He's one of the salespeople there. That dude, man, he has looked out for me. He's been great. really has. And I really appreciate everything that you're doing for me, my man. Just a great guy, man. So I appreciate it. And we'll get things, keep things rolling. But yeah. So like I said, that bike is for sale. And also, Stacy had put up on Facebook. I'll put it somewhere on here. Put it on Facebook that there's something, some kind of discount or incentive for rider coaches. So if you're a rider coach and you're looking to get one of these bikes, there's some kind of incentive that's going along with it. So and that's really cool. You know, they're looking out for people that are helping us stay safe. So that's great. Actually, and I went up there today, as you guys saw from one of my one of the YouTube shorts. I went and got a add-on for the bike. So while I was there, I noticed that they had another bike up there. So it looked kind of like the a cafe racer style, or like a naked Street Fighter style bike, and it was also another Zero. I'm sure you can get on the website and look at the different models and things. So they had in total 1, 2, 3. They had 4 different models. They had a Motard, and they also had a dirt bike, like an off-road, serious like off-road dirt bike, and they're all electric. So definitely get on the website, check them out. Check on Zero's website. Check on Savannah Motorsports website. If you're in the area, come down and take a look at them. These bikes are cool, man. Well worth the trip. And a big shout out to the homie Dwight out of Orlando, riding with his MRG. Man, look, hey, it's got. Look, I'm gonna have to come down to Florida. If your IMRG has another group ride or something like that, if you guys do it monthly or however that works out, I don't know, because I've never been a part of one. But if you guys have an IMRG ride or an event, a cookout, you know, whatever the case may be, hit me up, man. Let me know. Send me a message on YouTube here, or Facebook or Instagram or something. Let me know. I'll try my best to get down there. I will always take time out for a subscriber of the channel, man, because you guys make everything greater out here. Like I said, I love all the comments and everything, and I like talking to you guys. I love talking about motorcycles. I can talk about motorcycles all day long. So for sure, man, if you got anything going on, let me know. I'll come check it out. And hey, we'll just have a good time. With that said, man, we're going to go ahead and end this here. Ride every day. And most importantly, man, make sure you enjoy it. Come on, man. Hey, if you ain't enjoying it, man, what's the point of riding, right? So, all right, y'all, man. Peace.